Welcome back to Yes, I'm Adopted, Don't Make It Weird. It must be Tuesday because I'm still Dave-O, he's still Brett, and we're making it weird.
Wait, are we only Dave-O and Brett on Tuesday?
Yeah.
Is that what you're implying right
here? I think so. During the rest of the week, I go
Who
by...
Who am I?
I'm Megalodor, Destroyer of Worlds.
And I'm just the Adopted.
You're just the Adopted.
So, hey, we are trying something new. We got another camera angle. And we've had the camera for a long time, but we just sat it up there to try it.
Hey, camera angle.
We don't know if it's going to look weird or not. Chances are it's going to look real weird.
Where are you looking? Where are you looking right now?
I'm looking... Shoot, should we just have our own camera?
Keep looking at
Do I look at this camera the whole time and you look at that camera the whole time?
I think we want to cross.
Oh, so I went this way and you go that way. Okay. Nope. All right, Dave-O.
Okay.
Hit him with it.
So we're going to talk this week about our adoptee community here in our little town of Fenton and how almost all of the adoptees that we know have an ability to perform and a desire... And a desire... Most of the adoptees that we know in our area have this ability to perform or desire to perform. A lot of us are on stage, we're playing music, or we're giving speeches, or we're playing sports or doing all sorts of stuff. And a lot of us, our parents have either involved us in stuff or we've gotten involved in a lot of different things over the years and are really good at it. And there's a theory behind that that has to do with how... adoptees develop these what do you want to call them, these defense mechanisms, essentially, in order to blend in and mimic and blend into things. And so we're really good at that, at projecting and at being on stage and doing those things. But we hate practicing.
Hate it.
Almost universally, at least within our peer groups here, we hate it.
Mm-mm.
We
None
hate
of us are
practicing.
Good at practicing.
At least practicing in front of people.
So let's talk about that here a little bit. Now, my parents, they never forced me to do much. The only thing that I ever felt like I was forced to do was learn piano. I think that's like an Asian thing though, like you have to pick up a musical instrument like piano or, I don't know, violin seems to be a big one for
Does
a lot
to.
Of like Asians,
mm-hmm.
You know, or cello or viola, any kind of stringed instrument.
I didn't know you took piano lessons.
Yeah, I took piano lessons when I was 7 years old. Like, my piano teacher, she usually would only take people, like children who were like 10, 12 or up or something like that.
Mm-hmm.
But she made an exception for me because I was really good. Because I'm Asian.
At being Asian?
At being Asian and at piano playing, I assume. Actually, I was really bad at it. But my parents, they really wanted me to get involved. And I remember as a kid, I did too, but a lot of it was to make my parents happy. And that's why I did it. Because my mom was so excited when I said I wanted to take piano lessons. Like, she was ecstatic.
Mm-hmm.
And I wanted to make her happy. I remember, though, the piano that we had was in the living room in front of everybody.
Mm-hmm.
Like, everybody could hear me practice, everybody could hear me play. And I hated that with a passion. I hated that because I knew I wasn't any good. And every wrong note, I just felt like I was getting judged by my mom because my mom was an organ player. And I just felt like I was getting judged for every single wrong note I played because there were so many of them. And I hated it. It drove me crazy. I wanted to quit so many times.
That's funny.
But I never did because, again, I wanted to make my parents proud and I wanted them to be happy that I was doing something. What about you? You ever had to play piano
anything? I did take piano also for several years. And which is funny because my parents had literally zero musical ability. Like... none. But for some reason, they felt that it would be a good idea for me to get involved in theater groups and in music and all that kind of stuff, which honestly it was. It was a very good idea, and I'm glad they did that. I learned a lot from that. But here's what was frustrating for them was that I would practice, but I would sneak practice time, right?
Yep.
Because, like, again, I don't want to look stupid.
Yeah.
I'll go to great lengths to not look stupid, even when I know... I'm supposed to look stupid right now because that's practice, right? Like, that's what it is, and you're told that and whatever. But, like, I would sneak practice time during those times when my parents weren't around just because then they wouldn't hear me practice. And so they'd be like, how come you're not practicing?
Yep.
Why don't you practice? And then I would still get to the recitals or whatever and play everything perfectly. because I'd done that, and the practice is happening, but, like, it's very strange, because it makes me feel like, one, it makes me feel like I don't need to practice.
Right.
Right? Like,
I'm so good at this! Man, I am the greatest piano player ever!
I am naturally good, but we're not.
No.
At all.
Mm-mm.
Case in point, go watch our first vlog. And that's true of a lot of things, like team sports. Team sports? Did you do team sports?
I did soccer.
Okay.
For a couple years.
Uh-huh.
I was so bad at soccer. I was just the worst. I don't know why my parents wanted me to get involved in soccer or how I ended up in that point in life. But I just remember sitting on the ground playing defense, because that's all we, like, that's all you do as a kid. You just sit on the ground, wait for somebody to throw you the ball.
Right.
And I'm just sitting there and I'm like picking at the grass. I just remember, what choices have I made in my life to get here right now? First of all, I always wanted to skip practice.
Uh-huh.
I always wanted to skip practice. I hated, like, right. practicing in front of the other kids, practicing with the other kids. Right. It was just bad. And then they put me on defense, and all the kids who came at me were, like, four times my size.
Mm-hmm.
And when your coach is like, Carlton, get in front of him! Get in front! No! Ain't no way I am standing in front of this monster freight train of a child running at me full speed to save the ball. Not happening. However, I did find out through soccer that I am a very good sportsman. I got all the sportsmanship awards.
How many trophies did you get?
I got all. No, they weren't trophies. They were ribbons that they gave away at each game.
That's cheaper.
I got all of the sportsmanship ribbons because they felt so bad for this tiny little Asian who's like, please don't kick the ball at me. Just, I was such a good sport, guys.
I played baseball, which is, like, as far as team sports is concerned, is, like, the most individuals team sport that you can play.
Right.
Right? Because it's like, okay, well, as soon as the ball has left my hand, I'm done.
Yeah.
Like, I did it. I did my thing. Go team.
Yep.
Right? You can sit on the bench and just kind of, you know, whatever. And hey, you can practice that. You can practice throwing and catching for the most part by yourself.
Yeah, get one of those nets or whatever.
Right?
That they
and,
have.
And do that. Like, and that's great. And you only have to show up for team practice occasionally. And by that point, my hand-eye coordination was so well developed because I didn't want to look stupid at the practice.
Right.
Right? That I was pretty good at doing those things. But baseball was the only team sport I think I ever really could have played because of that. Because I can develop those skills on my own.
I never tried in soccer because I knew I wasn't good. And I didn't want to practice. And so I never actually asserted myself, or I never tried.
Mm-hmm.
But I never wanted to try really that hard because I knew I wasn't good.
Sure.
And so if you don't try, you can't fail, right? Yeah!
That's absolutely true. And today, as adults, if I'm being honest, I still have that same problem.
Me too.
It's terrible. It's
like in front of people, right?
Sure.
Practicing in front of people.
Yeah. Like I'll still practice. There are a lot of things that I'm better at today than I have been in the past.
Right.
But and I'm better about learning from people because that's why I'm there. So like that's taken a lot of intentional thinking and a lot of intentionality to just be like, okay, I need to learn this and I'm gonna look stupid.
Yep.
Right? But for me, here's the reframe, right? Now I can look stupid better than anybody else. I'm so good
and
at it.
That's your reasoning,
right? So okay, well now,
I love
now
it.
Who looked the stupidest?
Yeah.
And that allows me to be okay. But for the most part, like when it comes to learning new skills today, I still I have to practice solitary.
Me too.
The practicality of this is that, like, if you're going to enroll kids or if you are adoptees and you feel the way that we've felt, find ways to practice alone.
Yeah.
Right? Because we did it. We got better at stuff. We just had to do it on our own. And if you're like us also or you have kids that are like us, your best bet is to go ahead and put them in the thing or whatever. But just understand that, like, you're probably going to want to just put them in a room and close the door. And just be
let
like,
go.
Hope you figure it out.
Let them go. Yep.
Good luck.
Yeah. And some of them, you know, like if they want to be able to perform or they want to be able to play a musical instrument or anything like that, you know, they may not have the courage to come and ask necessarily. So parents out there, like, bring it up to your kids. Ask them if it's something that they'd be interested in. Because as a child, I never wanted to inconvenience my parents.
Right.
And I knew if I had to go to lessons or I had to do anything else, it was a time constraint. You know, it probably cost money. There were a bunch of other things. And so as a child, I would have steered away from that just because it was a slight inconvenience to them.
Or don't ask and just put them in there.
Or just do it and see what happens.
Yeah. That's what we did.
Yeah.
That's what happened to me.
Thank you for joining us on today's episode of Yes, I'm Adopted. Don't make it weird. We are so glad that you guys are still with us. Drop in the comments what you guys thought about today. If you are an adopted person, adult, teenager, child, it doesn't matter. Like, we want to hear your thoughts on practice. Do you guys like doing it? I don't think anybody likes practicing.
No, that's pretty universal. But
do you like practicing in front of people, or are you one of those people who just shies away and you have to go, like down here to just get away from people?
I'm gonna do it, but just over there.
I can't duck any further than this.
You could fall down.
This is... Oh, gosh! Please make sure to like, comment, share, and subscribe. Hit that like button if you're on Facebook. If you are watching on YouTube, we have an amazing Yes, I'm Adopted Facebook page for you guys to go check out. We have a group also on there that's growing. We have over 100 people that joined our group now.
Yeah.
I know, isn't that fun? So we get to have some conversation, get to joke around and answer you guys' questions. And we love being able to hear from you. So that is a place for you to be able to throw your own comments in there and tell us something that we don't know. Which is a lot.
It's a lot.
We're still learning things.
Huge amounts.
So thank you for joining us. I'm going to continue drinking my coffee.
Oh, we're drinking coffee this
week. Yeah, cheers. Cheers, Dalo, to coffee. That was super weird.
Yeah.